Today on Don't Talk TV, I want to take a look at the recent conviction of Canadian Armed Forces bombardier Chelsea Cogswell, in part because it's a perfect example of why you should never talk to the police, including military police. Hello, my name is Nicholas Wansbutter. I'm a criminal defense lawyer in Stratford, Ontario, Canada, and welcome to Don't Talk TV. So I've been doing a lot of content related to new laws surrounding COVID-19, but today I found a perfect opportunity to go back to the very core of what this channel is about. And the name of the channel is Don't Talk TV, because my recurring and most basic message is do not talk to the police. Earlier today, I was just looking around on an army discussion board that I frequent. I've been commenting back and forth with some other members on the case of Bombardier Cogswell as it's worked its way through the court process. And I saw today that there was a news story that she had been convicted. And after reading some more about that, it presents as a perfect example of why you don't talk to the police. Because in my view, from the information available, her giving a statement, in fact two statements, to military police was a key factor in her conviction, because otherwise I think it would have been a very difficult case to prove. It's also an interesting case to me because it involves the military, and it also unfortunately involves people abusing cannabis. And cases like this are very frustrating because they just perpetuate myths, stereotypes, and stigmas about cannabis. And Bombardier Cogswell has, in addition to destroying her own career, has really fed into those myths and stereotypes and has done her part to continue the stigmatization of the use of cannabis. Well, let's go to the article. Here's a CTV News article entitled "Canadian Soldier Found Guilty of Drugging Colleagues with Cannabis Cupcakes During Live Fire Exercise." So just for context, live fire exercise means they're using actual bullets, or in this case, actual artillery rounds, because this is an artillery exercise. So let's just go here. This gives the essentials of the case. It says, a military judge has found a Canadian soldier guilty of drugging her comrades with cannabis cupcakes during a live fire training exercise, calling her actions shockingly unacceptable. Bombardier Chelsea Cogswell was found guilty Wednesday of 9 charges, including 8 charges of administering a noxious substance and 1 charge of behaving in a disgraceful manner in the first trial of its kind in the Canadian military. Cogswell was operating a mobile canteen during Exercise Common Gunner, a major live fire drill involving up to 150 personnel on July 18th at Canadian Forces Base Gagetown in New Brunswick. Now here's one of the keys here. During 2 videotaped statements, Cogswell told military police that she had baked a dozen chocolate cupcakes for her fellow soldiers, but denied adding any cannabis to them. Other evidence included that 5 soldiers who provided urine samples tested positive for marijuana, while the wrapper from one of the cupcakes also tested positive for tetrahydrocannabinol, THC, the main psychoactive ingredient in marijuana. Basically, the case appears to be that a number of soldiers started acting strangely. There's descriptions of soldiers being confused, feeling paranoid. There's a description of one individual diving into a bag of Doritos. I mean, that's just so stereotypical. That one I kind of wonder about. I mean, how did a soldier get a bag of Doritos out at a live fire exercise, especially since that soldier is described as being very health conscious, someone who would never eat Doritos, and also someone who didn't smoke, and they said he was smoking cigarettes. So that seems a bit strange to me, because I've never, ever come across people under the influence of cannabis who do things that they otherwise wouldn't do. But aside from that, clearly there was evidence that there were soldiers acting in a strange way. They had to stop the live fire exercise because it was dangerous, because people were doing dangerous, stupid things. It's a bit shocking that soldiers, when they started feeling these effects, tried to carry on, but it's also kind of understandable, because having trained in CFB Gagetown myself, I can imagine the thoughts going through their head, thinking that if they go to one of their NCOs saying they're not feeling well, being accused of malingering and just not wanting to do their job, so they figure, well, I'll just tough it out. But as you can imagine, someone unknowingly eating probably more cannabis or THC than they normally would consume, when they're unknowingly consuming these cupcakes, would be really feeling some serious effects. Now, notice that only one wrapper tested positive for THC, and my understanding from other articles that I read is that that wrapper was found in the garbage. So it seems to me there'd be some serious evidentiary concerns about how do you prove that the wrapper has trace amounts of THC on it because it held a cannabis cupcake, and not because something else in that garbage had cannabis on it that touched that wrapper, especially when you only have one wrapper. It would be harder to make that argument if they had six wrappers and all of them had THC on them. Seems a bit of a coincidence, but when you only have one, it seems a bit tenuous. Perhaps more importantly, how do you prove who made the cupcakes? They say that this bombardier was running the field kitchen, but she wouldn't be the only one running the field kitchen. You don't have one person serving 150 people. There'd be a whole team of cooks and logistics people that would be running that field canteen. So without a confession from her, how do they prove she's the one that made the cupcakes? And so that brings us back to her statement. And this is, again, a perfect example of why you don't talk to the police and why you especially don't talk to the police when you think you have a defense. So she talked to them thinking she has a defense, saying, well, yeah, I made the cupcakes, but I didn't know there was cannabis going into them. But see, now she's just proved the connection between herself and the cupcakes that otherwise they may not have been able to prove. So she potentially sunk herself on the use of the cupcakes. Because, I mean, imagine how to prove that connection when you've got this live fire exercise. You've got these huge howitzers firing live rounds. I mean, I've been near one of those firing a blank, and I thought it seemed like the entire planet was shaking and the world was going to end. It was so loud. I can only imagine what live rounds would be like. And again, a whole team of kitchen staff, 150 soldiers, all kinds of people coming and going and things going on. But she handed the military police a crucial piece of evidence that at least played some role in her conviction. So again, don't talk to the police. Even if you're in the military, you still have the protection of Section 7 when it comes to being investigated criminally and the right to remain silent. So always keep that. Although that said, now that she's been convicted, and I assume that the rest of the evidence was worthy of a conviction, I hope they should throw the book at her, because the military court-martial judge is absolutely correct. I mean, it's beyond shock. I can't believe that someone would think this is even a remotely good idea, or even remotely funny, to be surreptitiously giving people cupcakes laced with cannabis in this sort of scenario. I mean, live fire exercises are already dangerous just by the fact that you're throwing around live rounds, in this case live artillery, with huge explosions. I mean, these things are meant to kill people. Of course, this video is not legal advice. If you have a situation where you need legal advice, contact a lawyer. You can call another lawyer or myself. My 1-855 number and my website are listed below, and we can give you specific advice tailored to your particular situation. If there's any topics you'd like to hear me talk about on this show, please either send an email to the email address listed below or leave a comment in the comments section. And if you found this video at all interesting, helpful, or informative, please consider liking, sharing, subscribing, following me on social media. And also keep in mind that Don't Talk TV is also available on Rumble if you're watching us on YouTube, and we're getting Odyssey set up as well in the event that I'm deplatformed on YouTube. So thank you for watching. I hope you'll join us again later this week.